Hello everybody, Alex here, welcome to my Finance and Accounting Education channel. Today we are finishing with the last tape jam from the United States. I started last week presenting the ones which were supposedly not so underperforming based on market and analyst evaluation. We talked about Alphabet and Amazon. I told you back then from both of them that I don't see the results as negative. We continued this week with Microsoft and then with Apple, which also have some tiny problems in the results. If you're asking me, Microsoft less, but Apple a little bit more. But they are considered widely by the analysts as being positive. Today we are going to do the last one, which will be Meta or Facebook. They went through this rebranding, and we will also see that the metrics which were considered by analysts in order to present the results of the previous quarter of Meta as being very, very bad, so as negative, somehow this quarter played in the opposite, so went in a different direction, and as a result the analysts consider these results very, very good. However, I have a different approach, and I'm looking at the financial results, I'm looking at the P&L and so on and so forth. I'm looking less at the estimates or guidances, I'm looking less at the commercial numbers and so on and so forth. I mean, they are of course relevant. I'm looking less at the forward looking statements. I'm just focusing on what really happened in the last quarter, and from my point of view the Facebook results are not that great, and what is positive about them is that they might turn to be actually good investment that they did in this quarter, but if you take the quarter as such, it's not extraordinary. That being said, I'm going to ask you to subscribe to my channel, doesn't cost you anything and it will help me a lot. If you hit the bell notification button, you will also not miss an update on my site. I do them quite regularly these days. You should expect new and hopefully interesting videos from me on Tuesdays, Thursdays and Sundays as well. And with that cleared, so out of the way, we can jump right in. So we have Meta Investors Relation page. Just as a reminder, I'm not a financial analyst, this is not financial advice. Your decision to buy or sell shares of Meta company or any other companies that are presented in my videos are yours and yours alone, and I take no responsibilities in your decision making. And also as a reminder and disclosure is that I own shares in all the five tech giants for the United States, so in Alphabet, Microsoft, Apple, Amazon and Meta. And I'm only using official numbers, so no numbers that are put together by myself, some personal estimates or something like this. Let's just go right into the press release. April 27, 2022, Menlo Park, California, Meta Platforms. Meta reports first quarter 2022 results. Finally, we have this week a company that has a normal fiscal year, which overlaps with the calendar year, because just as a reminder, the fiscal year or the financial year of Microsoft starts in the middle of the calendar year, and the fiscal year or the financial year of Apple starts with the latest quarter of the calendar year. We made progress this quarter across a number of key company priorities, and we remain confident in the long-term opportunities and growth that our product roadmap will unlock, said Mark Zuckerberg, Meta founder and CEO. More people use our services today than ever before, and I'm proud of how our products are serving people around the world. So we have the financial highlights of first quarter. Total revenue growing by 7%. Total costs and expenses unfortunately growing also by 31%. This is why I was telling you that taking as such the financial numbers of quarter one are not outstanding. Income from operations down 25% from 11.4 billion to 8.5 billion. Operating margin down by 12% from 43% to 41%. Provision for income taxes down by 28%. Effective tax rate from 17% to 16%. Net income down by 21% from 9.5 billion to 7.5 5 billion and diluted earnings per share down by 80% from 3.30 to 2.72. So if we are just taking these numbers, you can already see that they are not that good. The question was always to see in what are they investing, so why are the costs increasing? Then we have the commercial numbers, which I said that they are interesting. We need to look at them as well, but let's just say that I do not consider them fundamental in terms of what actually happened in the quarter. Because, for example, if you have how many daily active people, if you can have more advertising revenue, and let's just say that somehow you see that the revenues also grew by 7%. Although that 2.87 billion on average for March 2022, which is an increase of 6%. So with this increasing by only 6%, they managed to do a 7% increase in revenue, yeah. So there is a slight disconnection here. Family monthly active people, 3.64 billion as March 31st, 2022, an increase of 6% year over year. Facebook daily active users, 1.96 billion on average, an increase of 4% year over year. So you see the daily active users is actually growing only 4%. Again, the revenue grew by 7%. Facebook monthly active users were 2.94 billion, an increase of 3% year over year. So also an increase, but less than half of what revenue increase. Ad impressions and price per ad in the first quarter of 2022, ad impressions delivered across our family of apps increased by 15%. So you see actually the growing number of users got even more ads, and the average price per ad decreased by 8%. So you see this is actually good because it's making the advertising on Facebook more accessible to small and medium companies. Capital expenditures, including principal payments of on finance leases, were 5.5 billion for the first quarter of 2022. It would have been nice to also have some percentage of development here. Share repurchases, we repurchased 9.39 billion of our Class A common stock in the first quarter of 2022. As of March 31, 2022, we had 29.41 billion available and authorized for repurchases. Yeah, so I think they should continue to buy their shares. The shares are of all the companies are right now quite cheap, and they should do this because this is the advantage of companies that have actual net income. Although let's say the market, everybody's selling in the market, there are a lot of margin calls and a lot of bearish investors, being them institutional or individuals or private investors. Companies that have earnings and retained earnings, they can use the funds, so they have the net income, positive net income. They can use the funds to repurchase their own shares and to sustain the price of the shares. Cash and cash equivalents and marketable securities. Cash and cash equivalents and marketable securities were 43.89 billion as of March 31. Also, again, it would have been nice to have a percentage of development here. Headcount was 77.805, an increase of 28% year over year. Then there are some outlook commentaries. Second quarter revenue 28 to 30, which means an increase from 27.9, so they are expecting positive development. Total expenses 87.92 billion, so for the entire year, lowered from 90 to 95, which are good news. Capital expenditure range of 29 to 34 billion unchanged. Absent any changes to US tax law, we expect our full year 2022 tax rate to be above the first quarter rate and in the high teens. Okay, now going to the presentation, because they also have a presentation that was like a short press release. So we have advertising revenue by user geography. We are going to compare, of course, with the same quarter from 2021. We can also look the three quarters in between. But we see an increase in advertising revenue in US and Canada, slightly flat in Europe, substantial increase in Asia Pacific, and also some increase in the rest of the world, growing from 25 billion to 27 almost, so 25.4 to 27 billion in total. Then we have revenue by user geography, so this we have advertising revenue. Then we have revenue by user geography, somehow deteriorating with 270 million in the US and Canada. Europe also a little bit deteriorating, increase in Asia Pacific, also increase in rest of the world overall from 26.2 billion to 27.9 billion, an increase. Then we have segment results. Advertising 27 billion from 25.4 in the same quarter last year. Other 215 to 198. So this will be the family apps of apps revenue. Then the Reality Labs. This is their bet, the Meta, why they rebranded the Metaverse. We have actually an increase from 534 to 695 within the quarter, and the total revenue, of course, increased from 26.2 billion to 27.9, which is a positive development. Then we have, if we are looking at the operating income, we will see that the family of apps took a beating from 13.2 to 11.5 billion. And the Reality Labs, which is on an operating loss, the loss increased from 1.8 billion to 2.9 billion. And the total income from operations we have from 11.4 billion dropped to 8.5 billion, which means an operating margin loss of 12% from 43% to 31%. Expenses as a percentage of revenue. So now we see this 12%. Where is it coming from? It's very simple. You have a 2% troubles in the we cannot say in case of Meta because it's a software or internet company, cost of goods sold is cost of revenue. It's in research and development, actually most of it from 20% to 28%, just to be straight and clear. So in theory this might prove good on a longer term, because it's like an investment. 11% in marketing and sales, 12%. A slight increase in general administrative from 6% to 8%. We will come back later to the commentaries. Then we have the effective tax rate dropping from 17% to 16%, which is somehow a different development, and it's helping the company. It's different than what happened with Apple when I had this question, why is the effective tax rate increasing? Then if you are looking at net income, okay, we have the drop from 9.5 billions to 7.5 billions. Diluted earnings per share, the drop from 3.30 to 2.72. That's why I'm saying that Q1 is not that good. If you are looking also at the last quarters, it's below expectations from my point of view. Then you have the capital expenditures. Quarter on quarter, the growing from 4.4 to 5.5, or 5.5, and within the year 2020 to 2021 from 15 to 19. So it's clear that they are investing. Then we have again the family daily active people from the so the, this let's say consumer KPIs from 2.72 to 2.87. Which is probably what the analysts expect, and they want to see that the Facebook consumption is increasing. Family monthly active people growing from 3.45 to 3.64. Family average revenue per person from 7.75 to 7.72, quite flat, let's say. Facebook daily active users, if we are looking in slightly growth in Q1, we are talking about millions here in US and Canada, Europe a little bit reducing, large increase in Asia and Pacific, and in the rest of the world. So basically the increase is coming from mostly from Asia Pacific and rest of the world. Monthly active users also slight growth from US and Canada, reduction in Europe, an increase in Asia Pacific, and an increase also in the rest of the world. And then you have the per region, the average revenue per user. If we are looking worldwide, 9.27 to 9.54. The biggest, so within the quarter, the biggest revenue per user is coming from the US and Canada, 48.29. You would expect that. 15.35 from Europe, Asia Pacific 4.47, and 3.14 from the rest of the world. So it's clear that US and Canada and also Europe remain the strongest ones in terms of average revenue per user. And then you have in the appendix some free cash flow reconciliation, 8.5 billion in Q1 2022, Q1 2021 7.8. So the cash flow is looking quite good. The free cash flow, remember, the free cash flow is used by the company to pay the investor, so that's why it's relevant, not the total cash flow, because it's the sum of the operating cash flow and the investment cash flow. Because you will see it's net cash provided by operating activities, purchases of property and equipment, so these are the investment, and principal payments of finance leases, this is also investment, yeah. And from the free cash flow, you are actually paying the dividends, or let's just say doing share buybacks, or yeah, anything that's related to financing as well, paying debt if the company has debt, and so on and so forth. Again, we are going to go to the call, so to the transcript. We have Dave Wehner, CFO. Thanks, Shailen, and good afternoon, everyone. Let's begin with our consolidated results. All comparisons are on a year-over-year basis, unless otherwise noted. Q1 total revenue was 27.9 billion, up 7% or 10% on a constant currency basis. We've also seen by Microsoft using this constant currency for non-GAAP results. Had foreign exchange rates remained constant with Q1 of last year, total revenue would have been about 893 million higher. So they also had some headwind taking them, so reducing their revenues with 893 million. Q1 total expenses were 19.4 billion, up 31% compared to last year. In terms of the specific line items, cost of revenue increased 17%, driven primarily by core infrastructure investments. So you cannot say anything bad about core infrastructure. Payments to partner and content related costs. R&D increased 48%, mainly driven by hiring to support Family of Apps and Reality Labs. Marketing and sales increased by 60%, mainly driven by hiring and marketing spend. So they hired a lot of people, which means that they expect development in the next years, which can also prove to be a positive thing. So they are spending, their expenses are increasing, but it's not 100% negative. G&A increased 45%, driven mainly by legal-related costs and employee-related costs. We added over 5,800 net new hires in Q1, the majority in technical functions. We ended the quarter with over 77,800 full-time employees, up 28% compared to last year. So you see the company is still developing. If you are looking at the increase in the revenue, last year, for example, they had, when we took a look at the previous quarter, we had a 36% growth. Okay, this quarter is not that big, but on a year-to-year basis, the company is growing a lot, and of course, they need more employees. Then we have free cash flow. We repurchased 9.4 billion of our Class A common stock in the first quarter, and we ended the quarter with 43.9 billion in cash and marketable securities. And of course, if you want to read the transcript of the call or to watch the entire call, I'm just going to quickly scroll through it and see if between the questions, some are more interesting, some are less interesting. There are a lot of questions about the operating system from Apple, which somehow made Facebook take a beating in their advertising revenue because of the way the data is collected and the way the targeted advertising can be delivered and so on and so forth. So unfortunately, if the hardware companies are having trouble, maybe from the semiconductors like Apple, from the semiconductors crisis, from supply chains, from China's zero COVID policy and what happened in Shanghai, the shutdown of factories and so on and so forth, you see that internet companies such as Facebook are affected by what the hardware companies are deciding to do with the operating systems on their devices, being them fixed devices, mobile, tablet, and so on and so forth. So this might have been, because the answer is very long, this might have been a very interesting question. Thanks for taking the questions. First off, Mark, just curious, as AI curation of content takes over from social cues, I was hoping you could talk about what some of the biggest changes will be to the user experience and then perhaps monetization as well long term. And then second, in terms of Reels, how do you think about the timing for turning on ads more and what needs to happen in the product for that to happen? Remember that Facebook is having a lot of competition from this Chinese TikTok from ByteDance, is the company, I think. And they started to do Reels, and also Google is doing Shorts and so on and so forth. So they are trying to somehow put up a competition to this video that the younger generations, short videos that the younger generations seem to appreciate a lot. And I recommend to you, if you are interested in investing or finding out more about Facebook, to read all these questions. It's interesting content. Let's just say that not everything which is here present in these questions is strictly related to the results of Q1 2022. However, there might be interesting questions and answers which can inspire you. That would be it for today about Facebook, I hope, or Meta actually. I keep calling them Facebook. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Just remember, for Meta, for Facebook, the gameplay is how will Metaverse turn in the next years. I personally consider this to be a great opportunity, and I think the consumers will jump on it once it will be available with all the VR reality, with all the glasses and these things. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment in the comment section if you have something to add to the topic, share it with somebody that might be interested about Facebook and the latest results of this company, and most importantly, please do not forget to subscribe to my channel. It doesn't cost you anything and it will help me a lot. If you hit the bell notification button, you will also never miss an update on my site. I do them quite regularly these days. You should expect new and hopefully interesting videos from me on Tuesdays, Thursdays and Sundays as well. Below this video, you have links. You can create an eToro account and trade there without a commission or a fee. You will own the shares if you use your own money, but be careful because there are also some titles which are not available on eToro, but they are available only as CFDs, contracts for differences. You will also get CFDs if you trade leverage or with a margin. But no matter what kind of securities you are owning, and how often you are trading, not paying a commission or fee is always a saving, which is an advantage for you. I will come back within this month in the Who Wants to Be a Millionaire series with an estimation of how much it would have costed me the commissions and fees if I would have done it through my old bank brokerage and not through eToro. Below that link, you have another one with an Amazon wishlist with hardware and software items which can help me improve the quality of my videos, thus being beneficial for you. You will get better videos from me, but let's just be honest and say, from financial perspective, the Amazon wishlist is the most inconvenient for you. The easiest way to support me remains subscribe to my channel, hit the bell notification button, and of course, continue to watch my videos. Once again, my name is Alex Petescu. This is my Finance and Accounting Education channel. I thank you today for your time and patience. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I look forward to presenting to you with the next opportunity. Goodbye.